going on, vinyl community? Welcome to another video with the Record Spinner. In today's video, I am going to discuss how vinyl records are made. This is a concept that has been covered by a few VC channels, as well as various educational channels, but I figured I'd throw my two cents in and discuss what entails within the manufacturing of the media platform that we all know and love, that is vinyl records. Some of this may be common knowledge to those that are well aware of the process and what entails with it, but for those who don't know everything that entails, perhaps you'll learn something in this video. So, enough of the chit-chat, let's jump into what this video is all about. The first part of the whole vinyl manufacturing process starts with the lacquer. A lacquer is an aluminum disc that has a coating of thin paint, almost like nail polish, and has a very soft finish to it. Now, there are many variations of lacquers that are used within the vinyl world, such as dub plates, test acetates, or transcription discs. But for releases that are made available to the mainstream buying public, traditional studio lacquers are used. The first step of the process is cutting the lacquer, where the mastering engineer will cut grooves into the lacquer on a lathe at a mastering facility. Once the lacquer is finished being cut, it is indeed playable, just like a normal record, and then it gets shipped to the pressing plant. For large-scale vinyl releases, lacquers go through a three-step electroplating process. First, a thin layer of silver is sprayed onto the lacquer and then gets placed in a nickel bath. The electroplating process begins when an electrical charge fuses the nickel onto the silver lacquer. This creates a metal layer that gets peeled off of the lacquer, and it is essentially a negative of the lacquer that has a very rigid edge to it. This metal negative is known as the father or master of the process. The father gets electroplated again, and the metal layer that gets peeled off is positive, and it is known as the mother. The mother then gets electroplated, the metal layer that gets peeled off is a negative, and that is the stamper that will be used to press up records. Now keep in mind this, the father can produce up to 10 mothers, and then a mother can produce up to 10 stampers. Stampers can press up to 1,000 records before they start to wear out, so when you do the math, utilizing the three-step process will allow you to press up 100,000 copies, which is an adequate amount in this day and age considering that there are other media platforms that a consumer will gravitate towards. But back in the day where vinyl was the primary format, multiple lacquers would have to be made since they couldn't reuse the original ones that made up the fathers. For smaller scale vinyl releases, lacquers can go through a two-step electroplating process. The lacquer still gets sprayed with silver and is placed in the nickel bath, and then the metal layer that gets peeled off is the father. That father will then get converted to a stamper, and the whole mother process either gets bypassed or they shelve it for future use. Now you can make up to 11,000 records using this process, and the biggest indicator that you have a record that was manufactured using a two-step process is usually if it is a limited edition type of release and it states how many copies were made, whether it's in the tens of thousands or less. And I should mention that the pressing plant RTI has a unique way of indicating in the dead wax whether a record used a three or two step process, and that is indicated by the number in the parentheses. For super limited vinyl releases or releases that are prepared differently from lacquers, there is also a one-step electroplating process. Now, this process is normally done utilizing direct metal mastering, otherwise known as DMM, which is where instead of cutting grooves onto lacquers, you're actually cutting into copper. And normally in a three-step process, you would get your stampers from the mother. In the case of DMM, you're cutting directly into your mother, and then you use your finished mother to create the stampers. And I'm actually going to do a whole video about direct metal mastering in the future, which will dive deeper into the subject matter. Now, some of the audiophile companies use this process, but of course using standard lacquers. Analog Productions do the Ultra High Quality Record, or UHQR. Mobile Fidelity Sound Lab does the UltraDisc One-Step Record. With those types of audiophile releases, you are essentially creating your stampers from your lacquers, and you can only make up to so many records, and that's why those releases are always so limited. But the major advantage from a hi-fi perspective is that you are getting much more detail from the source material, as well as less surface noise that you would get on a traditional record. While the electroplating process differs depending on what is being pressed, the way vinyl records are pressed is the same across the board. The stampers get affixed into the press and the labels are prepared. polyvinyl chloride pellets get fed into a hopper where they are compressed to biscuits, which are usually 3 times as thick as the finished record. The biscuit and labels get placed into the press, and about 300 degrees Fahrenheit of steam and 2,000 pounds of pressure allow for the stampers to be pressed right into the vinyl. Now, while the record is getting pressed, there is some excess vinyl that ultimately gets trimmed off. Depending on the pressing plant, they will collect the scraps of excess vinyl and reground it into vinyl pellets and reuse them, which is a very neat way of being eco-friendly within this field. The last and most important step is quality control. Within a stack of freshly pressed vinyl records, a few copies will be selected at random for an audio and visual inspection. From an audio perspective, listeners are hearing for any swooshes or crackles that will distract a listener from the listening experience. From a visual perspective, they are checking for any defects such as non-fill, mispressed labels, and unwanted particles that could leach onto the vinyl. From what I have witnessed, pressing plants that maintain a great reputation will go through a very strict quality control process, and then plants that are just concerned with getting product out in the market as fast as possible will kind of let the quality control slip. So it's really important that this measure is taken into account, because you simply don't want to be releasing faulty product in the consumer market, and also minor nuances that could have easily been checked will frustrate a buyer. Once that last step is done, the records are shipped to the packaging supplier, and before you know it, a vinyl record release is in your hands. So there you guys go. That is how vinyl records are made. I really hope that you found this video informative and enjoyable. And if you did, please go ahead, give it a like, subscribe to the channel. And if you want to support this channel, be sure to check me out on Patreon. See you guys in the next video. And most importantly, keep the records spinning.